But I can't leave him.
Why not?
He'd get angry. And if he does this to me when he likes me, imagine what he'd do if he ever got mad.
So dump the chump, get a new guy, and let him protect you. And we've got just the one in mind.
A little botanical genius.
And she ain't talking no George Washington Carver.
See one?
Bingo.
No, we're just friends. No, I could never be Seymour's girl. I thought it passed.
And who amongst us has not?
Besides, I don't even deserve a sweet, considerate, suddenly successful guy like Seymour.
Mm-mm-mm. This child suffers from a low self-image.
You have a point.
She got a problem.
I know Seymour's great. But I'm dating a semi-sadist. So I got a black eye and my arms in a cast. Still, that Seymour's a cutie. Well, if not, he's got enough beauty. And I dream of a place where we could be together at last.
Where is that, honey? An emergency room?
Oh, no! It's just a daydream of mine. A little development I dream of. Just off the interstate and not fancy like Levittown. Just a little street in a little suburb far, far from urban Skid Row. The sweetest, greenest place where everybody has the same little lawn out front and the same little flagstone patio out back. And all the houses are so neat and pretty because they all look just alike. Oh, I dream about it all the time. Just me and a toaster and a sweet little guy like Seymour. A matchbox of our own. A fence of real chain link. A grill out on the patio. Disposal in the sink. A washer and a dryer. And an ironing machine. And the tract house that we share. Somewhere that's green. He rakes and trims the grass. He loves to mow and weed. I cook like Betty Crocker. And I look like Donna Reed. This between our frozen dinners and our bedtime, 9:15, we snuggle watching Lucy on a big, enormous 12-inch screen. His December bright, his father. Kids watch Howdy Doody.